Hello children, today we are doing a chapter and the name of the chapter is Animal Living and Surviving. So first of all, it's a very interesting chapter. Now we will be dividing animal into two groups. Those are your vertebrates and invertebrates. Now as the name suggests, invertebrates are animals which are without backbone and vertebrates are animals which are with the backbone. Usually your invertebrates includes insects, worms and many other small animals. And according to the research, it is said that 90% of most of the animals are invertebrate. That means they do not have a backbone. But the remaining are vertebrates. Now vertebrates are those animals which have backbone. And these vertebrates are divided into groups. Those are fish, amphibians, reptiles, birds and mammals. Now reptiles are those animals which lay eggs and which have dry skins and all, like your lizards, snakes and all. As you all know, birds are animals with feather and which are able to fly and which lay eggs. Amphibians are those animals which lives in both water and land. Example your frog and all. Then you finally have mammals which give birth to young ones. Example, dogs, dolphins, even human being comes under mammal. Now these are some of the classes of vertebrates. Now the main thing we need to remember. Now we need to see how animals survive in their environment. Like sometimes we have different conditions and all. So how is an animal able to adapt in that environment? Adapt means, how is it able to cope up in various environment? Sometimes in very hot areas, sometimes in very cold areas, or those kind of area which animals have lots of prey and all, which will hunt them. So in those area, how will it survive? We are going to see that. First of all, body covering of an animal. So outer covering of a body is very important. It will determine how an individual is going to survive in an area. First of all, we are going to see for an insect. Insect, as we know, they come under invertebrates. They do not have a backbone. So usually they have a very hard outer covering. So the outer covering, whenever you are observing any animal, let us say if you take an insect, let us say a cockroach, catch that cockroach and see its body, you will find that its body is of different kind. It usually have a hard kind of body. So most of the insects, they have hard bodies. Then you have reptile. So in reptile, you see their bodies are very dry kind. Example, your crocodiles and all. The reason because that is, in order to prevent water loss, their bodies are very dry kind of body. And even tortoise, whenever you are seeing a turtle, you find that it is a very dry animal and it has a big shell at its back. Now that shell is very useful to the turtle because it will protect itself from other bigger animal which will hunt them. It will protect them from the predators. Then you have fish. As we all know, fish have a scale in their body. As you can see out here, the scales. Now these scales protects the body inside the fish. And these scales are very flexible. So whenever fish is swimming in water, it will be having no problem with their scale. Then you have birds out there. So birds have three types. You see that birds are made out of the outer body covering is of the feather. You will find that the feathers are of three types. First one is the flight feather. Second one is contour feather. And third one is your down feather. Now flight feather, as the name suggests, it helps them to fly. So usually flight feather are present in their tail and some part of the wing. The contour feather, it provides the outer covering of the bird. So most of the part of the body are covered with this contour feather. And down feather grows to, and you see down feather grows close to the body of the bird. That keeps the body warm. So it's like down feather is a kind of insulator for the bird, which will keep their body warm. Then you have mammals. Now mammals, the outer covering are usually fur, wool, etc. on bristles. So this outer covering of the outer covering in the mammal protects them from cold climate condition. In human beings we have skins, and in some cases we also have a layer of fat beneath the skin, layer of fat which protect us from cold weather.